Hi, in this tutorial we will learn about the lathe modifier. Now, the lathe modifier is best used when you have an object, for example, this bottle or this cup, where if you look at it in the front view, if you slice it at any point, and if you look from top at this slice, you will see a circle. Now, in this case, the lathe modifier is perfect, is ideal. All you need to do is just forget about half of this image, just like cut it in half and draw the outline, and then the lathe modifier will place an axis, and the outline will be used to create this geometry around that axis. Also, in this tutorial, we will learn about a few other things, like how to set up an image to put it as a background to model in front of it. And also, I will touch upon the concept of implicit geometry versus explicit geometry briefly. And you will learn a few things. So let's get started. So activate the front viewport and maximize it using Alt-W. Create a plane. Now, I don't need all these subdivisions, so I will make it one by one. Make sure it is shaded using F3. Now I will drag this cup onto the plane. Now, as you can see, it is distorted because the size of this plane, the length and the width, they are not similar to the aspect ratio of this photo. It's not the numbers here, it's the aspect ratio. The aspect ratio is when you divide the width by the length. So I can use the UVW map, but also there is another way. I can right click, properties, details. For example, here the width is 518, so I will put 518 here. And the height is 740. Now, as you can see, it's not distorted. Now I can choose scale and scale uniformly the image. For the X, I will make it 0 to make it at the center. So now I will drag it backward, because when I model in the front viewport, I don't want my model to intersect with the image. Also, I like to freeze this image so I don't move it by accident. But the thing is, now if I choose freeze selection, I will not see the texture anymore. So unfreeze all, select the image, the plane, go to object properties and uncheck this option here, show frozen in gray. Now I can freeze it and I can still see the texture. Now go to shape. Before, I will right click and activate the grid point. Click snap, press the line. I want to start my line from this grid point, which is in the 000. This way I will be sure that I'm starting from the middle of this picture. Click. Now press S to go out from the snap, turn off the snap. We don't need it anymore. Now press Shift to constrain the line. Click. Now I'll press G to hide the grid. Now I will draw the line until here. I can fix the 2D shape here. Now, I will select this vertex, click Fillet, and drag to create a small fillet. I will call this cup main body. I will create another shape for the top part. Press Shift to create a vertical line. Press G again to see the grid. I will choose this vertex and I will right click this spinner on the X so it is in the middle here. Press G again to hide the grid. For this one, I will create small fillets here. Here we have a big fillet. Now for this one, I will undo, I will right click and choose smooth. here the nature of this vertex is busier, so it has this handle here. I can control the curvature. Okay, now let's add the lathe modifier. I will choose this one in the perspective viewport, go to the modifier lists, press the L, and this is the lathe. Now by default the axis of the lathe is in the middle, in the geometrical middle of this shape. It's here, as you can see. If I go here, I have three options. By default, it is center. If I click minimum, the axis will jump to the farthest point on the left, like this. If I click max, it will jump to the farthest point on the right side, and will end up something like this. Now we want the minimum. Now if I press F4 to see the wireframe version, you can see here that what this modifier does, it will take this profile and create 16 copy from it, and this is the default. We can change that. 16 copies around, if you count it, there are 16 around the axis. Now I can move the axis if I want, and it will connect the vertices, and where we have these closed loops of segments, we will have this face, these faces. Now, to increase the resolution, I can increase the number of segments, like for example 32, and it will become smoother. Also, if you look down, you see this artifact here. The thing is that when the lathe modifier creates these number of segments, here we have, for example, here we have 32 vertices in the same position. What we need to do to get rid of this artifact here is to weld these vertices, so we will end up with only one vertex. So click Weld Core, and now that's it. Now I will do the same with the top part. Also Weld Core. And now we have this. I will increase the segmentation, 64. We'll do the same with this one. Here we have this option not to have a full revolution around the axis. For example, if I want to have it like 90 degrees only, I can have this. Sometimes you want to do something like this. The flip flip normal, if you do the lathe and then you see that it's like this, it's black, that means the normals are flipped. You are looking at the back side of the polygon, so you can use this flip normal. In our case now, it is fine. Now I will talk about the explicit geometry versus the implicit geometry. Here we have 64 segments, as we can see here, and this is here we are talking about, what we are seeing is the explicit geometry, because what we see here is what we get. We control the resolution. I will bring back this number to 12, like make it low res, and I will click here patch instead of mesh. You can see that it becomes smooth. Now, what happens here, and as you can see, you don't see a lot of geometry. Well, under the hood, there is an algorithm that controls this operation. We don't have to worry about it, because the developers they create it in a certain way that it gives us the best resolution possible. Of course, there is a limit, so we don't crash the computer. But if you like to see the amount of geometry that this algorithm created, you can add an edit poly modifier on top. And as you can see, now you see what this algorithm did, how much geometry it added. So I will bring back this to mesh and make it 64 again. Another thing, I can go here to spline if I like to give thickness to this, and I can create an outline. I can click outline and click and drag a little bit. And now we have thickness. But there is something we should do here. It is better if we delete this segment here, so that the welding of the vertices here can work. I will bring this axis to zero again. For some reason it moved a little bit. So if we don't remove that segment, the welding will not work, because welding only works on naked edges. Here we have a naked vertices. Here we have naked vertices. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you like it. And if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you.